Hello students, today we will discuss about autonomic nervous system. The autonomic nervous system is divided into two parts, sympathetic system and parasympathetic system. The autonomic nervous system is a network of nerves and ganglia that controls involuntary physiological actions and it maintains internal homeostasis and stress responses. This system, that means autonomic nervous system, innervate structures within cardiovascular, pulmonary, endocrine, exocrine, GIT, genitourinary, and central nervous system. It also influences metabolism and thermal regulation. Autonomic nervous system is divided into two parts, that is sympathetic nervous system and parasympathetic nervous system. The effects of sympathetic stimulation are widespread across the body. In contrast, the parasympathetic nervous system stimulation tends to produce localized and discrete effects. Sympathetic and parasympathetic nervous system generally have opposing effects on the organs. In general, the functions of parasympathetic nervous system is homeostatic, whereas stimulation of sympathetic nervous system prepares the organ for stressful events. This is often called as fight or flight response. Now we will see anatomy of the sympathetic nervous system. The preganglionic sympathetic neurons originate from the intermediolateral columns of the thoracolumbar spinal cord. These myelinated fibers exit via the ventral root of spinal nerve and synapse with postganglionic fibers in paravertebral sympathetic ganglia. Unpaired prevertebral ganglia or terminal ganglion. The preganglionic neurons may ascend or descend the sympathetic chain before synapsing. The preganglionic neurons stimulate nicotinic cholinergic postganglionic neurons by releasing acetylcholine. The postganglionic adrenergic neurons synapse at targeted end organs and release norepinephrine. This is about anatomy of the sympathetic nervous system. Now we will see the location and names of ganglia. Easily identified paravertebral ganglia are found in cervical region, including stellate ganglion, and along thoracic, lumbar, and pelvic sympathetic trunk. Prevertebral ganglia are named in relation to major branches of the aorta and include celiac, superior inferior mesenteric, and renal ganglia. Terminal ganglia are located close to the organs that they serve. The practical significance of knowing location of some of the ganglia is that local anesthetic can be injected in the ganglion of these structures to produce sympathetic mediated pain. Now we will see, this is the figure showing neuronal anatomy of autonomic nervous system with respect to neurotransmitter. Now we will see the postganglionic adrenergic receptors of sympathetic nervous system and the effect of stimulating these receptors. There are alpha 1, alpha 2, beta 1 and beta 2 adrenergic receptors. The alpha 1, alpha 2 and beta 2 receptors are postsynaptic and are stimulated by neurotransmitter norepinephrine. The alpha 2 receptors are presynaptic and stimulation inhibits the release of norepinephrine, reducing overall autonomic response. Molecular pharmacologists have further subdivided these receptors, but this is beyond our scope. The dopamine stimulates postganglionic dopaminergic receptors. They are again classified as a D1 and D2. The response to receptor activation in different sites is described in the table. That means beta 1, effect of beta 1 on end organ, beta 1 adrenergic receptor stimulation on end organs. Beta 1 stimulation on heart causes increasing heart rate, contractility and conduction velocity. On fat cells, it causes lipolysis. Beta 1 effect, beta 1 adrenergic receptor stimulation effect on bronchioles is a dilatation. On uterus, it is relaxation. On kidney, renin secretion, liver, gluconeogenesis and glycogenolysis. On pancreas, insulin secretion. The end organ effect of alpha 1 adrenergic receptor stimulation. On blood vessel, it causes constriction. On in pancreas, it inhibits the insulin release. Intestine and bladder, it causes relaxation but constriction of the sphincters. Then alpha 2 adrenergic receptor stimulation effect on the end organs, that is alpha 2 stimulation organ presynaptic nerve endings, it inhibits norepinephrine release. Alpha 2 dopamine 1 on blood vessels, it dilates renal, coronary and splanchnic vessels. Dopamine 2 stimulation causes presynaptic endings, inhibition of norepinephrine release. Central nervous system, psychic disturbances. These are the end organ effects of adrenergic receptor stimulation. Now we will see anatomy and functions of parasympathetic nervous system. The preganglionic parasympathetic neurons originate from cranial nerves, 3rd, 7th, 9th and 10th, and sacral segments 2nd to S4, S2 to S4. Preganglionic parasympathetic neurons synapse with postganglionic neurons close to the targeted end organs, creating more discrete physiological effects. Both preganglionic and postganglionic parasympathetic neurons release acetylcholine. These cholinergic receptors are subclassified either nicotinic or muscarinic. The response to cholinergic stimulation is receptors, muscarinic receptors. The end organ effects of cholinergic receptor stimulation. When the muscarinic receptor stimulation on heart causes decrease in heart rate, decrease in contractility and conduction velocity. The bronchia effect on bronchioles is constriction. Then on salivary gland, stimulation of the secretion. Intestine, it will cause the contraction and relaxation of sphincters and stimulate secretion. On bladder, it will cause constipation and relaxation of the sphincter. Nicotinic effect on neuromuscular junction, it causes skeletal muscle contraction. And autonomic ganglia, it causes sympathetic nervous stimulation. These are the end organ effects of cholinergic receptor stimulation. Now we will see what are the catecholamines and which catecholamine occurs naturally and which are the synthetic catecholamines. The catecholamines are hydroxy substituted phenyl ethyl amines and stimulate adrenergic nerve endings. Norepinephrine, epinephrine and dopamine are naturally occurring catecholamines, where dopamine, isoproterenol are synthetic catecholamines. Now we will discuss synthesis of dopamine, norepinephrine and epinephrine. The amino acid tyrosine is actively transported into adrenergic presynaptic nerve terminal cytoplasm, where it is converted to dopamine by two enzymatic reactions. Number 1, hydroxylation of tyrosine. by tyroxine hydroxylase to dopamine and decarboxylation of dopamine by aromatic 1 amino acid decarboxylase. The dopamine is transported into storage vessels where it is hydroxylated by dopamine B hydroxylase to norepinephrine. The epinephrine is synthesized in adrenal medulla from norepinephrine through methylation by phenylethanolamine N-methyl transferase. Now we will see metabolism of norepinephrine. The norepinephrine is removed from synaptic junction by reuptake into presynaptic nerve terminals and metabolic breakdown. The reuptake is the most important mechanism and allows reuse of neurotransmitter. The enzyme monoamino oxidase MAO metabolizes norepinephrine within the neuronal cytoplasm. Both monoamino oxidase and catecholamine O methyltransferase metabolize the neurotransmitter at extraneural sites. The important metabolites are 3-methoxy, 4-hydroxy mandelic acid and metanephrine and normetanephrines. Now we will discuss the synthesis and degradation of acetylcholine. The cholinergic neurotransmitter acetylcholine is synthesized within presynaptic neuronal mitochondria by esterification of acetyl coenzyme A and choline by the enzyme choline acetyltransferase. It is then stored in synaptic vesicles until its release. After the release of acetylcholine is principally metabolized by acetylcholine esterase, a membrane-bound enzyme located in synaptic junction. Acetylcholine esterase is also located in other neuronal tissue such as erythrocytes. Thank you.